All right, number four. I want you to become their broker before you're their broker. Become their broker before you're their broker. What does this mean? Well, there was an interesting, actually a number of studies have been done asking agents, why do you leave your broker? Why do you leave the company that you're with? And one of the top answers that always comes back is this: I leave because I don't feel like I have a broker who appreciates me. I don't have a broker who appreciates me. I don't have a broker who likes me, who talks to me, who hangs out with me. And when we survey millennials, they talk about this even more. The number one reason they give for leaving a brokerage or leaving a company is because they feel like their broker didn't talk to them. They said they spent all this time talking to me, engaging with me, and recruiting me. And then I got in the door, and guess what? I don't talk to them anymore. I don't hear from them anymore. I don't even know if they know my name. Right? I just don't see them. They don't communicate. They're always out there talking to everybody else but me. And so what this does is this creates an incredible opportunity for you to do what their broker won't or can't do. You get the opportunity to start talking to their agents more than they do. And when you can build that relationship, you can now start to get them out of the company that they're with towards you. And there's a number of different ways to do this. There's all sorts of ideas out there. Judy was talking about some of them. If you were in her session, some great ideas. I've got a few I want to cover with you. The first, or the core concept here, is you want to relate and educate. And here's a couple ways you could do this. Number one is a value-added email, educational email updates that you send out. Gene, who's here from New Jersey, does this. He had an email newsletter that he was sending out once a week to the agents in his office. And what Gene decided to do is he said, well, I want to figure out a way to start sending this to people on my recruiting list that I want to hit. So he put together a list of the top 250 agents in his marketplace that he wants to recruit. Has this whole list put together. And what we did is we put together kind of a cover letter to the Monday morning update that goes out. A little cover email. And it's personalized. And so it says, hey, Mary, I was sending this out to my agents, and I thought of you. And I thought you might find this interesting. I send these out on a regular basis. If you don't want to receive them, let me know, and I won't send them to you. But if you find them valuable, do nothing, and I'll keep sending them to you. And what this has allowed him to do is reach out to them, to engage with them, to talk with them, to ask them out for a cup of coffee. And then what he did is he went on Facebook and we said, put together a list on Facebook with those 250 people, find them all on Facebook, as many as you can. And when you find them, friend them up and then start talking to them about their vacation. Start talking to them about what they're going on in their kids' lives. Start to build that relationship with them and then start inviting them out for coffee. And when you can do that, you're now positioning yourself as their broker, even though you're not. And when they look at that and they go, wait a minute, I hear from Gene more than I hear from my own broker. Why am I not working for Gene? If he does this for me and I don't even work for him, I wonder what it would be like if I actually did. That's the power of relating and educating people. Invite them to team functions. If you do a team function where you're doing training, you're doing something that you've got going on, maybe you're bringing in an outside trainer or you're doing a class or something that you're doing for just your team, maybe reevaluate and say, why don't we move it off-site so people don't have to feel weird walking in my office, you know, incognito, so that none of their friends recognize them walking in. Why don't I move it off-site and just market it as a value add to them? All right. Want to wrap up this section by saying this. With the millennial generation, people are greater than brands. They value their relationship with people more than they value their relationship with brands. You see, we hear about their attachment to brands like Apple. We hear about their attachment to their Apple products, and they just won't give it up because they're Apple fanboys or Apple fangirls. But the reality is, what sold them on Apple wasn't the product. It was Steve Jobs. And they related to Steve Jobs. They related to his vision. They connected with the man and bought the product. And what I want to encourage you to do, let them connect with you. Let them connect with your vision. Sell them on your vision for real estate, your vision for their life, your vision for what it is that you want them to be able to accomplish. That's your opportunity. Connect with them personally.